Vision after the cataract. How the modern IOLs changing the game and what visual results you might expect after the cataract surgery, choosing the different IOL types and the proper IOL. Hi there, my name is Alexey and you are at Eye Surgery Explained channel. As you know, I am talking about the intraocular lenses for years, and I have my blog and website IOLadvisor.com about the different IOLs, about visual experience, and that YouTube channel dedicated solely to cataract surgery and IOL exchange and your visual experience after the surgery. And today I'm going to talk about new IOL types available in the market, designed to improve depth of field, designed to improve spectacles freedom after the cataract surgery. And also I will talk about some misconceptions which are rise from wrong or too bold marketing messages of different companies. And some claims of the doctors, which also might lead you to misunderstanding of your expected visual outcomes after the surgery, which may lead to unsatisfactory results after the surgery because you expected something different. First of all, let's start about new IOL types. As you may know, the main disadvantage and the main concern about the every modern IOL is lack of accommodation. What is accommodation, why it is important, you can read on my website with a nice animation. Link to my website will be in the description below. It is IOLadviser.com, where you can read something about the accommodation, basic IOL types, etc. So, the lack of accommodation is a limiting factor of any intraocular lens of today to deliver you the same sharp, bright and seamless vision as you had, 20, 40, 30 years ago, back to your 20s. Even if we'll talk about the commercially available accommodative lenses, we still have problems with them. They are either not able to provide the full range of accommodation which you might need for the full range of vision without glasses, and or they are not able to provide you with that accommodation for many, many years. So for many commercially available lenses, the range of accommodation declines with the age. And with new technologies on a track, on a development, I don't know when and how it will be available. Probably will never develop the accommodative lens. So let's talk about the modern landscape, about the monofocal lenses and lenses which provide you with pseudo accommodation, which is designed to give you a spectacle freedom, but without using the natural accommodation mechanism. Nowadays we have basically monofocal lenses and then lenses which provide you with pseudo accommodation like enhanced monofocals, extended range of vision lenses based on EDOF technologies, and full range of vision lenses based on multifocal technologies and hybrid technologies, which provides you either two or three multiple focal points to give you spectacle freedom at near, intermediate, and far range. Talking about that scope of lenses, we have to understand that given the more spectacle freedom range, we decrease contrast sensitivity and we decrease quality of night vision when the pupil size increases and we use the full optical power of the lens, which is delivers you the full range of vision for at any distances. And the problem is that different type of lenses and different models of the lenses based on the material, based on the optical size design, based on various factors, including your corneal profile, including your retina status, including your pupil size, pupil centration. So all these factors end up with a different visual quality after the surgery. And of course, we have number of manufacturers. It's not that much, but still we have 4 to 5 major manufacturers which are trying to, win your heart, to explain surgeons and you as a patient that their particular lens is the best in class, which is not always the case, and you have to dig deeper to understand how the optical performance claimed in the marketing materials was really obtained. Because, for example, we have different models how to measure the contrast sensitivity. We have ISO model and we have ACE model, which are totally different in terms of the approach to the measurement and, of course, in terms of the results obtained. And normally this information is provided in vast majority of cases, but honestly, sometimes not. And even if it's provided, it's written in a small font somewhere in the back of the brochure, and you never, never read about that. But at the end of the day, you start your day with a new lens and understand that it's not exactly what you have expected. But generally, the main idea what you have to know nowadays, the situation is not that bad. The situation now is way better than we had 30 or 40 years ago. Because 40 years ago, we had only monofocal lenses, which was able to provide you with just a correction of refractive errors like myopia or hyperopia, that's it. But we still have astigmatism, and 40 or 45 years ago, we doesn't have an ability to correct astigmatism of intraocular lens. And that's why with the monofocal lens of that ages, you either had to use far vision glasses correcting astigmatism if you have a severe one, and reading glasses because you have a monofocal lens. Then later it was an era of development of toric lenses which corrects astigmatism. And that's why marketing started to say that if you correct your astigmatism, you will not need the glasses, meaning that you will need a far vision glasses to correct astigmatism. And honestly, even nowadays, this misconception of astigmatism correction means that some people expect that if they use a toric lens, they will not need the glasses for all the distances with monofocal lens, which not is the case. And to be spectacle free, you have to step out of the selection of monofocal lens. Just put it out of the equation, despite it is, let's say, in many cases, it's covered by insurance or reimbursement. The better options nowadays is at least enhanced monofocal lenses. To give you some examples of these lenses, of these enhanced monofocals, some models, it's just it's something like Technis Eyhance, BNL or Bausch plus Lomb Aspira, and if I'm not mistaken, Hoya Vivinex, something else, more or less. So all these lenses will provide you with improved intermediate comparing with monofocal, but even though all these lenses perform slightly different. Then if you move to next scope of lenses, then the next, let's say, cohort of lenses is presbyopia mitigating, presbyopia correcting lenses, which are so-called extended range of vision or extended depth of focus lenses, which provides you with a better intermediate and functional near, because enhanced monofocal in the vast majority of cases are not able to provide you with good reading ability, unless the lens will be calculated at slightly myopic shift at -1 or -1.5 to give you better reading. But if you aim with a monofocal lens at better reading, you will lose your far vision ability and you will need to use a glasses for good far vision. And presbyopia correcting lenses are designed to avoid that drawbacks, and they are designed to provide you with far intermediate and even functional near. And among that type of lenses, I might name something like well-known Alcon Verity, Technis Symphony, which was the best lens in terms of contrast sensitivity in that domain for years, and now it is replaced by Technis Pure C. Then it might be Bausch & Lomb IC8, which is quite specific lens in that domain, and BNL Look Smart lens. Still legally in that domain, like extended range vision lenses, you might have found at size IT Lara. What else I cannot hear? It's maybe Swin's Advanced Optic Lenses, SAV IOLs, which are also quite interesting, but quite specific, and it doesn't make sense to discuss it right now because it's a lot of things to talk and to dig deeper about that lens. I hope that my video will be seen by as much patient as possible, because the topics which I'm explaining here are normally not known to vast majority of patients, and many patients just having a cataract go to the surgeon, listen to the surgeon, get only one opinion, get the lens which they believe the best one, and they never know that they probably might have the better options. So if you like that video, please subscribe to my channel. Please give me thumbs up. Please write me something in the comment below. And the most and most important point is to share that video among other people who might need that information, who might need to have more knowledge about the lenses, who is planning to undergo cataract surgery soon. Because the more we spread the knowledge, the more knowledge we have as a patient, the more power we do have in selection of the best option for our lives to improve quality of our vision and improve quality of our life. Because if you have less information, you have less power. If you have more information, you have more power, you have more freedom to choose. And my personal aim to fight for freedom of patients, to know everything in my domain, and I'm being a patient in any other domains, I would like to have the same access to all the information in the world available to understand my visual options. Because unfortunately, sometimes healthcare professionals might limit us in knowledge for whatever reason. And we as a patient deserve to know more. And at the end of the day, it is so-called full range of vision lenses, which are aimed to provide you with a full range of vision in terms of far, intermediate, and reading distance. But Nowadays, talking about the extended range of vision or EDOF lenses and full range of vision like trifocal or hybrid lenses, we have to distinguish between night vision, because night vision has a specific with all the different intraocular lenses. I have a special video dedicated to that topic on my channel, so have a look to the description below and I will put it in that corner as well. So, coming back to night vision. Modern EDOF lenses like extended range vision lenses has not that much problems with night vision comparing to full range of vision lenses, but extended range vision provide you less depth of field and worse near reading ability comparing to full range of vision lenses. Well, it is not always the case because it depends on pupils and an amount of light around. It is another topic to discuss. So before I step into the full range of vision lenses, let me offer you a good option where to know all the details about the intraocular lenses. It is my website IOL-adviser.com, where you can read something about lenses. But what is more important, I recently launched my proprietary trained artificial intelligence assistant, which will guide you through all the lenses. From the, let's say, basic IOL type selection based on your answers. Or you can ask him or her, whatever you prefer, but I name him. So you can ask whatever questions you want to know about the different IOLs. And what is important, till the end of the June, this assistant will be free of charge. So if you're watching this video right now and it's still not July of the 2024, you're able to use it for free. After that, it will be paid version because I have to pay for artificial intelligence model, I have to pay for all the infrastructure, and of course I need income which will compensate my time which I spend to training to that assistant, collecting the proper answers, collecting the information and giving it to the appropriate managed my knowledge database. So nowadays, feel free to talk to that model directly and free of charge. If you will have any doubts, any questions, model will provide you with my email and my personal consultation page. From the 1st of July, the model will become paid, but it will still way more cheaper than my personal consultation. And if you compare my personal consultation with 1 hour only, you have access for your price for the model for 3 months. You can ask your questions today, you can ask your questions later, you can recover in your memory something else. You can discuss with your student, you will need some clarification. It's everything you will be able to discuss with the model. So just for one single fee, you'll get the full access to the full knowledge base for 3 months. So don't miss the opportunity right now or even after the 1st of July. It's a great offer which you will find never on the internet. Let's move further to the full range of vision lenses. The full range of vision lenses will provide you a good vision at far, at intermediate and near. Of course, I mentioned you about the night vision issues, but talking about the full range of vision, it's still some drawbacks, some limitations like near vision. The best near vision distance is slightly different among the different lenses. Intermediate vision distance is also different among the different lenses. So if you are choosing the exact model for yourself and you have some specific requirements in terms of visual distance at intermediate, especially if you're working with a computer with a smaller screen or larger screen, it's better to discuss with your doctor or with my AI model which exactly model is better suited for your particular visual needs, because it's simple optics and the specifications of the optic which will influence your visual outcomes is very important to, let's say, to consider with your eye health, with your retinal health, your refractive target, and possible defocus curve shift of the intraocular lens. What lenses are available in that domain? It's well-known Alcon Panoptics. It's also well-known Technis Synergy, which is recently replaced by Technis Odyssey in the United States. So what else? Quite a lot. On some markets, Medicontro available, on some markets, Hanita, Hoya, again, SEV IOL, and all the lenses are different. Generally, talking about the all scope of intraocular lenses, I can say you that every single lens is not a perfect, but majority of the lenses are quite good. And the most important for you is to match your individual visual needs with a particular IOL model selected. And it is important for you to discuss with your doctor and to find a doctor who really understands your visual needs, who can hear you, and who understands well all the drawbacks and limitations and let's say advantages of the technologies he has. There are some problems like not every IOL model available in every market or at every clinic, even inside of one country, because clinics tend to work with one or maximum two brands of lenses for a number of reasons. And sometimes it's challenging for you to find a clinic which can offer you a lens which suits you to the best to your particular case. And here is, you know, honestly, I have some doctors in my experience who are brave enough. If they face a patient who is a good candidate for the lens they don't have, they're able to offer or to suggest another clinic and send that patient to their colleagues. Some doctors are not so brave, and sometimes they try to, let's say, motivate you to choose the lenses among the range. Sometimes you simply don't have a choice because in your country some models are not registered, like Pure C nowadays in the United States or Odyssey nowadays in Europe. So it depends. Sometimes patients are able to travel or willing to travel to a different country. So nowadays we have a lot of options to have a great vision after the cataract surgery, to have a spectacle freedom, or to have a maximum contrast sensitivity, or have the highest standard of night visual acuity, or have the longest depth of field thanks to a pseudo accommodation. So the world is yours.